Hello, everybody, and welcome back to The Order, 1886. The last time that we left off, we had started the game, and we were in prison, and then we were out hunting some inmates that turned out to be half-breeds, werewolves. And when we left off, we were here at the round table, discussing what should be done about,
what do you mean?
You know, with the matters at Whitechapel and everything, and, the Supreme Lord Chancellor, he wasn't really, a fan of, going to Whitechapel. He believed it was a matter for the the civil authorities. And he's talking to a grain, but we're gonna go after Sir Percival. So yeah, this is the round table, and as you can see, it has different coats of arms that go all the way around the table. So, you also saw within that they had, like, he said Lord Darwin, Charles Darwin. A lot of famous people connected with the Order.
Galahad will deal with this in due time. I have a more pressing matter to attend.
As you wish.
How many of us will make the journey to
That's
America?
Nikola Tesla, by the way,
Lord
right there.
Barrett, Lord Darwin, and myself.
I've heard many great things about the Agamemnon, Lord Hastings.
Oh, she is the finest the United India Company has ever built. I can promise you a pleasant and speedy journey across the Atlantic.
Can we expect your presence at the launch, Sir Lucan?
Would be my honor to see you off on your maiden voyage, my lords.
Sir Lucan, if I may.
If you would permit me, my lords.
Of course, Sir Percival.
Alistair.
Excuse my
you
phone.
Know, as well as I do, the Whitechapel is the key to these disturbances, to everything.
My opinion is immaterial. The council has spoken.
Few dead countermand your father's express wishes.
Need I remind you that we all serve at the Lord Chancellor's pleasure?
You are the Knight Commander! Make him see reason.
You think an incursion into a rebel stronghold is reasonable?
I consider it an acceptable risk.
One for which you'd be willing to accept full responsibility should unforeseen circumstances arise.
Let what befalls be upon my head, no one else's.
Whitechapel remains off limits. That is, officially.
You have my thanks, Sir Lucan.
Of your thanks, I have no need. Bring me results.
As the Knight Commander wishes.
So he's going to go to Whitechapel
well,
anyway.
Most excellent. When do we move?
You're not talking about Whitechapel. But my
brother sought fit to permit us a reconnaissance. Secure the necessary materials. Isabel, a word.
Tell me, monsieur, about the Lord Chancellor.
What is a Marquis?
Sir Lucan and Lady Igraine were adopted by him, yes?
Yes, they were.
Why would he bring them into such struggle?
Perhaps he wanted to regain a semblance of the humanity he lost. When time came to join the Order, the choice was theirs to make.
Regardless, I would not wish this life on my children.
Marquis, we need to hurry.
Oui, mon général. Avec plaisir. Monsieur.
Friend Mallory has always been something of a rogue operative.
I've never known a better man.
Still. I shall rely on you to be a, call it a sobering influence.
Sebastian and I have long been partners. I trust him with my life.
A little restraint would not be ill-advised. Do look after my sister, won't you?
No man in the realm can keep Isabeau from danger when she's of a mind.
Oh, you say true. What's a brother to do, eh? Good luck and Godspeed.
So yeah,
at your service, Sir Galahad.
Is a so Igraine and Lucan are brother and sister.
Just the man.
And yeah, this is as I mentioned earlier, Nikola Tesla. quite young, of course. But a genius, nonetheless.
What new developments do you have to show me?
Quite a few intriguing things, if I may say so. Any further news of the trouble in Grosvenor Square?
Police are investigating. And investigating.
Lycans, on the United India Company's front doorstep, what do you make of it?
Mayfair isn't what it used to be.
Permit me to oversee a few of my new experiments. In the meanwhile, take a look around. Play with whatever strikes your fancy. But do be careful.
So yeah, the thing with the Lycans is that they've been at war with the Order for quite a long time. For centuries.
Nicola, how fares your friend Edison these days?
Thomas and I are not on speaking terms. The man is an idiot.
The War of Currents comes to London, Crystal Palace, Thomas Edison, two of the greatest minds of our generation to meet face to face. So yeah, Thomas Edison, thing is that when it came to him and Tesla, they were not friends. There was a lot of things that Tesla did that Thomas Edison kind of took idea from. And it's still debated to this day whether or not Edison stole a lot of ideas from Tesla. But, yeah, just like in the real world, in this world, Thomas Edison and Nikola Tesla are not friends, so...
gibberish to me. Nicola. You sly dog.
It's, it looks like, looks like a schematic for, like, a battery pack of some kind. You know, Nikola Tesla, he made a lot of things with Tesla coils. These, this is like his grand design.
Quite an antique. Hard to believe we ever use these communicators.
So yeah, this is a communicator. As you can see, it's made out of Tesla coils. And the communicator that they have now is the one that you see on their back right there.
Sir Galahad.
Oh, hold on. Still looking around. There's a rifle here.
Sir Galahad.
Alright, I'm coming. Shut the fuck up. Yes, yeah, so we're actually going to be taking this thing that's here on the table.
Please, this way.
Yeah.
Here is something you may find interesting. This device allows you to convert between Edison's inefficient direct current and my superior alternating current. Quite handy for overloading and incapacitating certain electrical systems.
So it's a, basically a, an old-fashioned jumper box, if you're wondering.
It's comprised of an inverter, transformer, and rectifier outfitted with some brass clips to enhance the design. Oh, and a fine leather carrying case. Inside each tube is a small quantity of mercury. When the mercury is properly aligned, the device becomes operational. Please, try it.
Pretty cool, huh? So you want to basically hold them in the red marks. And there you go.
I'd appreciate your expert opinion on my latest whimsy.
S-684 marksman carbine. Impressive.
You've always had a good eye for craftsmanship. I've outfitted this one with a telescopic sight. It's ideal for long-range shooting. I would be honored if you would test its efficacy.
With pleasure.
Skills never cease to amaze me. Good shot.
There we go. So we can also toggle the magnification. L3 to steady the aim, of course. Dead on.
Some muffling might be in order as well.
I'll attend to it immediately. So, are there any other of my children that you would like to meet?
The offer's tempting, but I must return to the others.
Of course. Well, the monocular that General Lafayette requested is over there on the table.
I'll see that he gets it.
So yeah, Tesla's quite the genius to come up with all these things. He's a heavy inventor.
He creates a lot of things for the Order, which is... You and Lafayette take the high street cool. from the south end. Galahad and I will move in from the north.
Why not give the Frenchman to Galahad?
Mademoiselle doubts my intentions. I promise to remain at all times the picture of chivalry.
I'd prefer to have someone more experienced looking out for me.
I thought you needed no looking after.
Very well. You team with Galahad.
Mademoiselle will perhaps one day allow me to demonstrate my skill.
One day?
Remember, we are entering rebel territory. The insurgents will take umbrage at our incursion into Whitechapel.
Given our little discovery in Mayfair, the London Hospital should be our target.
Strange to think Lycans would find sanctuary here, is it not, monsieur?
You really believe the rebels are collaborating with the half-breeds?
The Lord Chancellor is convinced of it. I have my doubts.
Do you trust anyone, mon général?
Never accept, always question. It's a motto that's seen me through the centuries.
Stay vigilant, all of you. We can expect hot work here.
Ah, quelle joie!
A nest of cut purses, collaborators, and whoremongers. I knew it very differently once.
All right, 15th day of October. We're now in Whitechapel.
Offering sanctuary to travelers.
So it's not difficult to think
that
the rebels and the half-breeds would collaborate together. They're both disliked by the royalty, so just makes them stronger to team up together. So welcome to Whitechapel, the home of
as it used to be, Sebastian. True.
Death and destruction, as it were. A place that at this time was a place you really wanted to avoid. There's something in there, especially if you were a prostitute.
We rendezvous at the hospital. Stay on your guard. Understood.
This way, monsieur.
All right, back up the stairs. God damn. There There's a pipe here. The ashes are
still warm.
Yep. The ashes are still cindering. Business.
Strange place.
All these people are poor. They live in places like this. What do we have here? Rations, rinse, and redemption. At the presentation of 4 pennies, you should be provided shelter from the cold, sustenance of a meal, sleep accommodations, warmth per a tarpaulin, compassion of the Lord. For one night till dawn. So there you go. Yeah, Whitechapel was a very, very poor part of England.
To be grateful for a few bob a week. Children worked to the bone in the Black Hallow coal mines while the captains of industry feast from silver bowls. Is this the England we want?
No!
What must we do?
Fight!
That's right. Brothers and sisters, fight. Join our cause. Down with the Queen!
Down with the Queen!
Down with Empire!
Down with Empire!
Down with the Queen!
Down with the Queen!
Down with Empire!
Down with
the
Queen!
Down with Empire!
Who was the John?
So yeah, the rebels were very against the Empire.
She's dead because of you!
Bravo, monsieur. Didn't care to dirty your aristocratic hands. It's all right. There's no need to be afraid.
How could I have known he was a ripper? It was just another blow.
You killed another one last night.
I didn't know.
Leave her be, monsieur.
I didn't know.
Don't worry. You're safe now.
So, of course, yeah, the Ripper has everyone on edge. If you don't know a lot about the Jack the Ripper killings, it was a really big blow to the people of Whitechapel, but you know,
through this door.
The thing with the rest of England was that the crown was very up in arms about the Ripper murders because of the fact that they were so gruesome, and also they happened so quick that it was unlike anything they'd ever seen before. Assault on Mayfair. That's from the Mayfair district yesterday morning with patients first believed to have escaped from the bed. So this is about, basically about what happened yesterday, and when we went to the London Underground and got the half-breeds. So, yeah, we're not going to read that whole thing because we already went through it. But yeah, so the murders, they happened so quickly, when they were so vicious, especially the last two, victims 4 and 5, they were extremely vicious, brutal murders that were unlike really anything they had ever seen. That's right, so the vibration diminishes the shear line, engages the pin, you have to... There we go. It's all about a feel, you can't really see it. It's pretty cool, an automatic lockpick.
No weapons allowed in the establishment. You want to stay, you leave it here.
Bien sûr, monsieur. As a matter of fact, we were just looking for the coat closet.
Give it here. And have fun, governor.
At ease, monsieur.
The quick we didn't take our knives, though.
Seems imperative.
Bella Muses. Zelda. Zelda was quite the common gypsy name these days.
The Ravens of London. They're getting organized.
Ravens of London armband. Stage. It's a note. Is it like in my archive? No. Sometimes I wish there was a way to like
Major General Lafayette.
Like see, you know, like see the text better. So it's like I have not as yet offended to one, I don't know. I can't read it. It's very hard for me to read. I see lycanthropy in there and half breed. So yeah, I can't read it. But if you can read it, there you go. Typical Lafayette.
Marquis, this is no time for sport.
Here comes that lady we saw earlier. She's Indian.
I have just a thing, monsieur. If one of you ladies would reach into my pocket.
Give it here, love.
Is it sufficient, monsieur?
More than sufficient, I'd say.
Upstairs, then, if you please.
Well, you know, sometimes his... He gets himself into things, and he's gonna have the money to back it up.
Not ready, love. You won't forget this, I tell you.
Well.
This way, love.
Get in here.
Oi! Here! What are you up to?
You're in the wrong room.
Where's the little frog gone?
He's in there.
With his friend.
Oi! Get out of
Hello?
Excuse us. Don't do it. Yeah, there's a little bit of male nudity for you. Just a tad. He's covering it up now, but it was just a tad, just a little bit.
Hello, monsieur. What do we do now?
Well, we got this door. That's what we do now. Is there anything over here? Some plants. Alright, up we go.
We have intruders. Get your weapons. Let's go.
Oh. Planning in this room. They're trying to come after us, but we're a little bit ahead of them.
Like we've stirred the nest.
Yep. They're preparing for a fight. So yeah, you can see how well packed together Whitechapel is. Whitechapel looks better today.
Keep a lookout, Marquis. I need to find a way through here.
I shall be there.
You know, just like with every country, there are poor parts. But Whitechapel isn't nearly as bad. Sons and Daughters of Britain.
Sons and Daughters of Britain, be merry and joyful, for we have entered a new era of prosperity. Today, our glorious empire the relentless march of progress as Her Majesty's army and royal knights keep a watchful eye over our motherland, holding the half-breed threat at bay. The United India Company hoists our beloved Union Jack across the globe. As you and your children enjoy the satisfaction of an honorable day's work, our factories produce goods that make England proud. As each day dawns on our magnificent empire, the sun shines on a brighter future than ever before. The future that you could be part of. Every day, ordinary citizens stand up and seize opportunities that bring them riches and a better tomorrow. You could be next. So I ask you, children of Britain, are you doing your part? Be a benefit to England. Bring honor to the Empire.
A message from the Conservative Party, October 1886. So yeah, kind of an advertisement, but kind of like a political message, like, hey, don't let the half-breed people run around. I mean, would anybody want werewolves running around, I guess? That's the real question. Was that it? Oh, so we can shimmy across here. That's right. And up into the house. Okay. Let's see here.
it's not the other way around. You know, two shorts for knights and one long for bobbies.
Does it matter? Just keep
Rebel
you
down!
Bastard!
So this basically fires two rounds in a row.
Perhaps the rooftops are not our best path, monsieur.
You may be right. We need to find another way to the hospital.
Anything in here? Anything I can take? I don't think I've killed anybody with the MK1 revolver yet. I think there's a trophy for killing people with every weapon. And I don't remember if I have it or not.
I found a way out.
And once you start moving fast, you start moving fast. So you, like, so you kind of have to look around a little bit. So yeah, this is like the automatic rifle. Which we'll get later as well. So I think that it's fine not having it now. They really just kind of give you the option of like, hey, you have a couple weapons you can choose from. Oh. Here we go.
Trop facile, hein?
You say too easy, but hey, man.
I sense that we are not welcome.
Keep your eyes open. We don't want to create any further commotion.
Just kind of looking for anything that I can pick up.
Look, monsieur. God did not save this queen.
Hey, man.
Move.
Lafayette, keep your head down. Take out the
monsieur.
Shit.
There he goes.
I need to reload.
Out.
I'm reloading.
Move up to here. Grab the automatic.
Rebel neutralized.
Okay, we good?
Lafayette. Take the street.
Oui.
Okay, we have the marksman carbine.
Oh,
another grenade.
Enemy down.
There we go.
We have to keep moving. I imagine more rebels are on their way.
What are these flashing over here? There's another smoke grenade.
They blocked the way. Through the building.
What, this one here? Yes.
Monsieur, shotgun is coming out of the building.
Rebel down.
Okay, let's see here. Later, sir.
Understood, Marquis.
I'm out of ammo. That guy's still alive.
Enemy down.
Down here. I have a shotgun. Oh, blew his head off. Damn it.
We need to keep moving and get off the streets.
Ah, repeating pistol, finally. Alright, so I have ammo for the shotgun, but I don't really want the shotgun. Honestly, would prefer the rifle. Oh, grenade. sec. Check right here.
A little help with the wagon, monsieur?
Yes, I'm aware. Grenade as well. I prefer the automatic weapons, though, just because, you know, they're much easier to kill enemies with, and you can fire them pretty, like you don't have to really fire them rapidly. This. It's a comic. Poverty, regress. Political comic, if you will. Alright. So, up here we go.
Percival, do you read me?
Save your breath, monsieur. The buildings are blocking the signal.
Curse of progress. Hand me your monocular. I can see our target. The hospital is 2 miles west.
Do you see our comrades?
Not yet. There. It must be them.
Shall we join the soiree?
We shall.
Let's invite a few friends, shall we? Air Command, this is Galahad. I need response from anyone in the vicinity of Whitechapel. Air Command, this is Galahad.
Link, monsieur.
You copy?
We are without sanction here. The Lord Chancellor will be most displeased. Lafayette does not fancy a court-martial.
We'll worry about that later.
Sir Galahad, this is Sentinel 5. We are 3 leagues northeast of Whitechapel. Please state directives.
Sentinel 5, this is Galahad. We require air support on standby.
Acknowledge, Sir Galahad. We are signaling blue-red at a 1 second interval. We request your visual confirmation for heading change.
So you have to send the Morse code.
Galahad, this is Sentinel 5. We have visual confirmation of your position. Heading change to 224 degrees. Assuming holding pattern above Whitechapel in 8 minutes.
So yeah.
Acknowledge Sentinel 5.
These blimps
wait further orders at
are used for like air support.
Let's go.
It's pretty cool shit. Like I said, you know, with this alternate kind of like history type stuff is always really cool to me. And
the smell of pestilence.
The Parisian slums.
Especially in a time like the late 1800s. With everything as advanced as it is, I think it's pretty cool. Could you imagine what living in 2020 would be like? If this was the form of technology now?
Not to worry, monsieur. I'm alright.
You sure you're alright? Yeah, there's a little Sackboy in the game. Little PlayStation reference. He's cute. I like it. That's like literally at a point where you couldn't really miss it, so.
Not our time be better spent hunting half-breeds.
Patience, Marquis.
This world is patience, always patience.
We're gonna get the flank on them. Oh.
Leave that, Jimmy. Get going. Come on, I'll cover our bases.
Yes, sir.
Come on, let's go. Move.
Let's move.
I'll give it to him.
Strike out! Constable, keep your head down!
Yes, sir! They've got me pinned from below!
Yeah, I can't really... Oh! Got me. I guess I was supposed to hit circle. I was trying to move the joystick, so I was.
Hey!
Ouch. Thanks.
Stopped for a pint, did you?
We encountered some resistance.
The rebels are better armed than we expected. Those markings look familiar.
It's one of ours.
So they're using our weapons.
Follow me.
Not just their own weapons. They have the knight's weapons as well.
There is enough firepower here for a small army.
Some of this ordnance was manufactured for the Order. Igraine even found an arc gun in here.
Oh, shit.
I was unaware that we had lost some of our inventory.
We haven't. Here, give me a hand with this one.
We haven't lost it. It was given to them.
See what's in there.
What did you find?
Essex M86.
Thermite rifle.
They saw their first field action a few weeks ago.
So yeah, this gun is a badass gun.
This one hasn't been assigned yet. How did the rebels get their hands on these?
I'm making it my business to find out.
Begging your pardon, sir. You need it upstairs.
That's our cue.
Just take this thermite rifle and use it against them, shall we?
I believe Mademoiselle requires our attention.
Igraine, we're in position!
About time!
Zap.
Move out!
took you all so long?
Well, you know.
Nice. Engage it well.
Understood.
So yeah, you basically fire these powder that ignites in the flame like that. I gotta bring him inside? Yeah.
Take his arms. Gently, monsieur.
I am in. Ready. Let's move him.
We're sitting ducks out here.
Here comes another.
Monsieur, only a few more feet to go.
We're clear. Move in.
Right, go.
That doesn't look too good, Percival.
Help me with that bookcase.
That went well.
So yeah, the Blackwater heals all their wounds and shit.
How bad is it? A punctured lung, I think. Another bullet through the stomach.
Map that has a bunch of locations marked on it.
You're going to be all right.
Crooked Crown, the three Stugards, Brick and Briar and Rose, TMW Royce, London Docks.
I think I've found our way out.
Everyone stand back. Igniting!
There you go. Thermite just burned through that whole thing.
Can we move him?
It no longer matters, monsieur.
He's dead.
Save your prayers, Lafayette. There is no god to help him.
Come on. Let's go.
There, the hospital.
We're only a few hundred yards away.
And these rebel gobshites will be waiting for us.
I need to reload.
Rebel down!
Down.
Mon de Dieu! Who built this fucking town? Dead ends everywhere!
Quite the shortcut. Brilliant. What now?
Lafayette, monocular.
you behind those columns!
We need to press forward now.
There's a weak spot in the tracks. If I can get up there, I should be able to bring the structure down. Igraine, Lafayette, I'll need you to provide cover. Percival, with me.
Watch it. Good here. Oh, actually.
Galahad, use the thermite to bring the bridge down.
The thermite is in place. Watch yourselves below.
Goes. Oh, Jesus. Wrecked the damn thing.
Looks like the rebels are retreating.
Let's move forward.
Okay, well, I think we're going to stop it there. Actually, here, let's see what this paper says. Rule Britannia, but where is the Queen? Citizens throughout the realm have expressed their consternation at Her Majesty's curious withdrawal from the public as a wave of strange tidings continue to overtake London. A cordon of security, invisible to the public, remains tightly wrapped around Buckingham Palace in the wake of disturbances in Mayfair and a rash of mayhem committed by denizens of the city's underworld. It's right strange if you ask me, observed Mr. Crace, a fishmonger in Covent Garden. A word from Her Majesty would put people's minds at rest. The fishmonger's sentiments were echoed by many in the bustling market district. I don't give never mind to rumors and wives' tales, says Mrs. Turnbridge, a grocer. But still, all this talk is poor insane creatures running amok and rebels everywhere. That's bad for business. The Lord Great Chamberlain sought to assure the public that there existed no reason for concern.
Her Majesty at present is attending to important matters of state that render it impossible for her to maintain her prior public schedule, the Great Chamberlain said. He added, though she regrets her isolation from her beloved subjects, Her Majesty wishes them to know that they remain close to her heart, and always in her thoughts.
When queried on the subject, the Lord Great Chamberlain refused to comment on speculation that the Queen is being kept deliberately isolated as a consequence of threats to her royal person from insurrectionists responsible for the late civic disruptions. Commissioner Doyle of Scotland Yard likewise exhorted the public to detest from what he called unfounded, irresponsible speculations, saying that the citizens of London need have no undue concerns for Her Majesty's safety. Few of those citizens encountered by the correspondent took comfort from the commissioner's words.
You can be there's things ain't telling us, said a tavern keeper who refused to give his name,
Over a pint of bitter, another person... I'm trying to make sure I'm reading within the quotes. Over a pint of bitter, another person... A patron scoffed. If the police have things in hand, the way they say, why aren't all these knights running around on some nefarious business such either, eh? At present, London remains a nervous city, full of suspicions and questions. In the opinion of this paper, answers must soon be forthcoming, lest the present unrest spiral into utter chaos. To the Lord Great Chamberlain, we say, show us the Queen. Let her speak for herself. So yeah, basically, Queen Victoria, who was queen at the time, she's not in the public eye, which is, when you have a leader that's kind of not in the public eye, there's usually something going on that's wrong. So, by the way, if you're English and you thought any of my English accents were bad, I don't blame you, but I try. Alright, so we're going to stop it there, and we'll continue on the next one. So, take care, and goodbye.